threats. Don't allow the ones that stop. Don't allow the ones that say it's too dangerous to continue. But if you'll just press, you'll make it. You'll make it. That's a word for somebody. You'll make it. The storm is real. The threat is real. But we serve a real God. Hallelujah. A real God that really cares about us. He said, I'm concerned about you. I'm concerned about everything that happens with you. And then there's no storm. There's no storm that is even full that I'll allow to take you out. I don't care how many other places it takes out. I don't care how much damage it does all around you. But when I called you, I promised you. If you'll just keep walking, you'll just keep going, you'll just keep pressing. So see, some of us see people in words that in the midst of your storm, somebody's looking at you. Somebody's depending on you to keep going. Somebody's depending on you to not stop. See, we get so caught all up in thinking the storm is about us and about taking us out. The storm is about refining you. The storm is about giving you strength. The storm is about even refining whose hope you believe. Whose hope do we believe? Who do we believe in on this earth? Who do we trust in on this earth? We trust in the Lord, not in the flesh, not people. See, if we trust in people, then they told us to say in our society, they said the storm, they're telling our people,
thank you.
but we have to be ready. Amen. I'm gonna stand on what I've been standing on for many years. It's Jeremiah 29:11. And it says, "For I know the thoughts that I think toward you, saith the Lord. Thoughts of peace, not evil. To give you an expected end." If you were like me, some of you may already know my testimony. God gave me this word. And it took me almost 10 years to get to that place of where I felt like I had ended suffering. But I gained so much strength in those years. Because you know what, Mama? I never lost hope. I knew he had already spoken me, and so I knew he was going to bring me out. Some days it didn't feel like I was out. Some days it seemed like trouble multiplied against me. And I would get bad news after bad news after bad news. But I continued to confess what he said. Mom, you said, you know the thoughts you have concerning me. Thoughts of good and not evil to bring me to my extended end. See, I don't want God to bring me to the end that people have for me. Because see, some people are wishing for your demise. But his desires are to bless us and to increase us even the more. But we got to stay in the race. We got to stay in the fight. Now God knows that if you go into the gym and you in the fight and you trying to just look like you work out and you ain't really doing anything. Coming to church and roaming around and not allowing it. Y'all know it's people in the gym. They get all the pretty clothes and they go get on every piece of equipment and sit down and maybe push it one time and move around. It's people that do that in the body of Christ. They go from place to place in the church. All that help you there. They don't ever get anywhere and get grounded and allow friction to begin to make them. Because until you begin to use these muscles and do sets over and over again, you ain't building nothing. Trials and troubles, they come to all of us. But the Bible says these are our light afflictions. Light afflictions.
Make sure that your soul is anchored this morning.
store. They come. And many of us, because we have profession, we press our way open. Because we know we got to be here. People are depending on us. Sometimes that we work in plants and certain jobs and professions that they depend on us to be there. In the house of God, you got to know that somebody is depending on your prayer. Somebody is depending on you to show up and say, yes, it was a real storm. Yeah, there was one.